Hi, everybody. My name is Daniel Gickelhorn. I'm a product director for our cloud CDN products in Azure's networking team. And I'm really excited about today's talk. This is a really frequent area of questions that we get around how to build best practice architectures in Azure for internet-facing services. And so I'm really excited to be able to cover this with you today and to really dig into some of these key areas and common misses when customers are building websites on Azure. So first off, I think we've all had a lot of difficult experiences over the last 18 months as things have changed with COVID, but that really has caused a fundamental shift, not just in kind of our daily lives, but really fundamentally in how web applications are being built and how IT applications are changing in the cloud. Things like work from home and new scale needs have made internet first services a mandate for many companies. And a lot of new security drivers are forcing applications to think about new application architectures as they're building cloud services and as they're transforming applications from on-prem to cloud. Through that transformation comes a large set of new challenges, especially if you're going from something that's not internet-facing to an internet-first application. A couple of really key stats up front. 96% of applications have really one, at least one vulnerability in them. And over the last 18 months, we've seen exploits during COVID and attacks growing more than 50%. This comes as more applications become internet facing, but also as the sort of risks and the value of those applications increase. And so with that change really increases the mandate for applications to both have a story that covers security and performance and the balance between those two things. Through this talk, we'll cover a few different topics around how you do that, but really fundamentally, we'll talk about how do you use Microsoft's content delivery network solution to protect your application while ensuring fast, reliable delivery at a global scale wherever your users are across the globe. I've spent a lot of time speaking with developers and application owners, and really one area that is fundamentally missing from the way that many folks have thought about building applications is they've thought through the client tier and they've thought through the application tier, but they're really missing an interim layer, which is an internet tier. And that's really there to understand how do you connect that application tier to your user tier, and how do you protect that application tier against threats and other scale issues that come from having an internet-facing web service. Azure's application delivery product suite is something we've built over the last few years to really address this problem and how do you handle internet-facing services. It's a collection of products that enable security, reliability, scale, and performance in an integral way with your application. We enable this at a global scope and at a regional scope for your applications, and we deeply attach it to our security suite, either within the global scope products like Azure CDN, Azure Front Door, but also regionally within things like Application Gateway. Azure Front Door is a service we launched a few years ago to really take this to the next level. Azure Front Door is Microsoft's cloud-native global content and application delivery service, and enables you to really easily encrypt user-to-user communication and apply threat protection to your applications and protect it against a common set of threats. We also provide the highest compliance certification of any global public CDN today on the platform. So it was really built for enterprise scale applications and really applications that need to think more horizontally about their security portfolio. It provides dynamic application acceleration to improve performance. It provides a baseline set of capabilities on our global network that I'll talk about in a second around global content delivery. We're releasing a new set of SKUs in preview that better enable our customers to enable more advanced security options and to improve the developer experience that allows you to enable more automation and to combine dynamic and static experiences into one. Azure Front Door is built on Microsoft's huge top-performing global network. It enables applications to leverage Microsoft's assets to build high availability, high performance experiences on our global network that we've spent the last 20 years developing, both for Microsoft's own products as well as for our customers. Our network is constantly expanding. In fact, it's recently expanded into new and deeper markets in areas like Morocco and Angola, and even some deeper markets in the United States in areas like Jacksonville and Tampa. it's a huge investment that continues to grow, and it's an area where using services like Frontdoor carry you forward with the expansion of that network over time as well. So now I'm going to talk about a core set of areas around best practices for building internet-facing architectures. Fundamentally, with Frontdoor, this breaks into three pillars. One, how do you protect your application from threats, and how do you ensure that it has consistent scale over time? How do you accelerate your application to improve the performance of the application and ensure that it has consistent performance over time? And finally, how do you automate common tasks with that to ensure that you're not just building availability into the protection and reliability of the service, but you're building it into the reliability of your CI/CD pipelines and your development of your application, including this internet tier. I'm going to break this down into two specific areas. One, which is really how do you get the most you can quickly from Azure Frontdoor service, which I call good, which is basically how do you get started fast without having to do a lot of work, and how do you get sort of things that are enabled by default or with limited configuration. And then second, cover some of the more advanced capabilities that you get that add a lot of value to the product that require a little bit more management and configuration. To get started with your application, the first thing you want to think about is protection. And fundamentally, how do you protect your application from these global attacks and from unknowns? How do you make sure that you're ensuring brand reliability and consistency with your application and how your users experience it even when you're under attack? I'm going to go through a set of different capabilities here, both in the good or sort of easy out of the box level, as well as how to enhance that with sort of a better tier of more advanced capabilities. So first is you really have to think about how do you secure your traffic coming into your website. Frontdoor allows you to get a free SSL certificate that you can very quickly deploy and scale your application to a secure footprint. It's something that's really simple to deploy, and it's the easiest way in Azure to upgrade your services to SSL and do that at a global scale. We also let you configure your application and force traffic to be encrypted, so you don't just have traffic coming in that might also be unencrypted, but Frontdoor makes it really easy with its rules platform to be able to add a redirect that forces traffic coming into your website to upgrade to SSL or to upgrade to HTTPS and ensure that no connections come in unsecured. We also let you add WAF, and WAF is really fundamental to how do you think about unknown and known threats for your application. We provide a robust web application firewall platform that lets you configure a combination of managed rules and bot rules to ensure that you're protecting against defaults for security in your application. What that means is really fundamentally ensuring that you have control over the known knowns that may be attacking your application, and leveraging Microsoft's experience in this space with our global threat protection to ensure that you have the best of breed when it comes to those set of rules and defaults that you can protect your application with. In addition, and this is something that's really commonly missed when configuring web application firewall, is when you're building a global service and you're adding something like a tier to your application, you have to think about not just the positive scenarios, like how does it work if the user is not blocked, but you have to think through scenarios like what is the user experience someone gets when they're blocked from WAF. And so one of the really common areas that's missed is really configuring the WAF on Frontdoor to be able to give a user experience in the block case. And that can either signal mobile devices or things like that that need to react if they get blocked by WAF, but also any users that come in that could be potentially misclassified or otherwise. And so that's something that's really fundamental to add when you're adding WAF to your service, is configuring that error message. And Frontdoor makes it really easy to do that and to make it simple to configure. And finally, in the default category, is enabling access logging. And I can't recommend this enough, is being able to really understand the behavior your users are experiencing and to build custom dashboards and custom playbooks for how you understand your users, not just today, but over time. Frontdoor makes it easy to enable logging with a couple of clicks, and you can send it to the myriad of different services in Azure that lets you consume, process, manage those logs, and use them to understand the behavior for your users. This is particularly useful because Frontdoor is a global service, and so you can then see the traffic coming into your application from wherever it comes across the globe, regardless of the application endpoint that it's landing, or the origin or the backend that it's landing on in Azure. Taking protection to the next level, there's a couple of really key scenarios to think through. The first is, once you've got the basics and you're protected against sort of basic WAF risks, is extending that to add things like rate limiting to your application with Frontdoor, which lets you manage user expectations and even manage the expectations that you have yourselves about how much traffic you'd expect from a single user. That's really helpful to protect applications from bots and other high-scale threats, including, in many cases, developers themselves who might be adding test tools for an app to an application. And then next, and this is something new with our Frontdoor service, is enabling private link. And that's really to prevent your backends from becoming internet facing and to ensure that they are protected and they don't have any public IP. This is really fundamentally a huge value change in Frontdoor as we go to the new preview capabilities in Frontdoor Premium, which is enabling private links so that you can secure access to the origin. As I mentioned, there's no public IP. And it allows you to really extend your zero trust story that you're building for your application out to the CDN or out to Frontdoor as well, and treat all of that in a single perimeter. It's something that we're really happy and is really one of the highest demand items that we're rolling out right now. And it's something that for enterprise services is something you should fundamentally think about. Next is acceleration. And this really comes down to managing the performance of your application. And there's a lot that you get from Frontdoor by default by using the platform that you don't get just by having a public IP on Azure or on a different cloud. The first is that instead of having a regional IP, you get a global IP, and that IP is managed by Frontdoor, both in terms of how does it govern traffic in and out of our network, but how does it also manage internet reliability in front of Frontdoor from issues. We have an active set of tools within our arsenal that we use to be able to quickly detect and automatically route around internet issues that you get when you onboard to the Frontdoor platform. The second is Frontdoor is inherently a global load balancer. And so when you use us as a global load balancer, there's a capability to be able to route traffic based on regressions and latency of your application. And it's not something that you can do with Azure Traffic Manager or other DNS-based load balancers. And we provide the ability to quickly route around issues at the origin, not just if there's some sort of reliability drop, but also in the case of some sort of performance degradation that you might see. If you have a multi-region setup and one region regresses in terms of performance, we can fail traffic over to another endpoint because we're doing a level of active probing. And then finally, by default, is really enable caching. And Frontdoor does this intelligently, where we don't enable caching by default because we assume that you're building a set of sort of hybrid or sort of dynamic plus static applications together. It's something that you can configure very granularly by route and be able to enable when you need it. But that can very quickly allow you to move content out from your origin to the application edge, and for us to be able to serve it for you globally from the edge of our network. Taking that a step further, there's a couple of key areas that you can take. One is enabling compression on the fly, especially for mobile device experiences. And this is really critical to be able to compress content as it goes over small wireless networks, wireless uplinks, and things like that. It's very easy to turn on, but something you have to consider based on the number of devices that you have. And then second is tuning your load balancing settings. By default, we pick some sets of defaults that are good for many applications that in about 30 seconds fail over when there's some sort of degradation in your application. You can tune that to be quicker based on how your application responds to health probes and how we manage your traffic through some settings in Frontdoor. And so that's the next area to really click into to really tighten up the performance acceleration that Frontdoor provides. Finally, really getting into how do you automate your application using Frontdoor and how do you use it to automate your operational scenarios for delivering your service. The first and really common is really how do you ensure that you have SSL certificate rotation. If you're using a Frontdoor managed certificate, like I mentioned before, we'll rotate that for you. You now don't have to think about how to rotate your certificate or keep it fresh on the site. The second, and this is really kind of the first step, and it's very easy to set up alerts in Azure using Azure Alerting and log analytics and other different capabilities, but really setting up alerts to check if your origin is responding with bad responses like 400s and 500 spike, or if the health probes that we're sending detect that there's been some sort of failure in your origin. The fundamental availability will be managed by Frontdoor because it'll fail away from origins that are exhibiting those type of failures. But it's also something that will give you much quicker access to go repair a situation, even if Frontdoor is keeping your users up while your origin is having issues. And then finally, Frontdoor, because it's integrated with the rest of the Azure ecosystem and the Azure automation capabilities, it allows you to write PowerShell scripts or other automated scripting to be able to manage your Frontdoor instances automatically. And what that means when you're thinking about developing applications with Frontdoor is really the ability to automate common developer activities or things that you work through with your CI/CD pipeline. If you are building applications that take a dependency on sort of a deployment phase and things like that, you can automate the changes to Frontdoor through that process. You can use it also to automate more major changes to your website, like adding new microservices to your website, because Frontdoor lets you configure route-based rules and things like that. And finally, in the automation category, sort of the next steps there are really to take this to the next level is really integrating Frontdoor with the rest of our ecosystem. One is using Azure Sentinel to create playbooks and accelerate your response to attacks. There's a huge, rich amount of data that you can access from Azure Sentinel that will let you really build that operational practice around how do you respond to web, application threats and issues on a regular basis. And then last, which is something we'll cover in some subsequent videos as well, is adding a backup origin to your website so that you really have a disaster experience. If you, for example, accidentally delete something major on your website and you experience a global failure, having a disaster experience so your users don't see a downsite but see a sort of a backup experience is really critical there. And it happens more than I think we'd all like to think it does. Finally, in this space, we've added a set of more advanced analytics with the new premium and standard versions of Frontdoor that are, as I mentioned, are in preview, that really expand your access to real-time data and expand your operational experience when you're trying to understand the traffic and behavior of your services coming in. We give you a view into sort of the global source of your traffic and give you a new map graphic, as well as a set of telemetry that give you deep insights into the behavior of your traffic, both in terms of just the traffic arriving as well as the security of your service. So through this talk, I've covered a set of really key best practices and go-dos for using Frontdoor to add this delivery tier to your application. In particular, we dug into a set of really easy, kind of good out-of-the-box capabilities that you can really quickly get from Frontdoor to be able to enhance your application experience quickly, and a set of more advanced or better capabilities that let you extend that value further. Every web application in Azure should have a delivery tier, and I'm really looking forward to seeing more applications and more of the conversations that I'm having with customers really talk about how do they enhance this delivery tier further in the near future. If you want to learn more about Azure Frontdoor, you can go to azure.com/frontdoor, and that will link you to all of our documentation and other services. And really happy to talk to you today. Thank you.